Today on Typical Books, we'll talk a little bit about what I've been reading lately and some books that I picked up at the Mammoth Book Sale. Well, it's a Mammoth Library Sale. It's the Friends of the Ottawa Public Library. But first, speaking of friends to Lydia's library, my darling husband is the best friend to my library. This is Notice by Heather Lewis. You may have heard a lot about Notice by watching my fellow booktuber pal, Criminolly. Ollie has talked about this book and had a part to play in getting the interest to have it republished again. So it had a storied past, and I'm very interested in reading this because it is one of the most harrowing and, if not the most disturbing book that Ollie has read. And I think that he's talked about another book since then that may be the most disturbing, but this is the most heart-wrenching and terrible book from what I recall. I've been looking forward to reading it. I had it on my list for a while, and then out of the blue, Chris bought it for me. So thank you, honey, for buying this. We'll see if that thank you sticks, because apparently it is very disturbing. We watch a lot of disturbing movies and read disturbing books and enjoy disturbing like graphic novels and stuff in this house. We are huge fans of the Bookubus Bleak Week, and I like to tune in and watch what they have to say about the films that they've watched or books that they've read, specifically films for Bleak Week. So if you haven't tuned into the Bookubus to check out Bleak Week, then I highly recommend it. So we're no stranger to things that are terrible and harrowing and disturbing on a deeply moral, ethical level. And Notice apparently hits all of those notes. So I'm looking forward to reading this. But that definitely takes a mood. So I don't know if I'll get to that while it's nice and sunny and happy outside. I think that may be something reading in the bleak November. I don't know. Maybe there'll be a bleak week during this nice and sunny time. Maybe it's better to watch and read terrible things like, say, Jack Ketchum's The Girl Next Door. When would you like to read that? In the most terrible, bleak, terrible November, on that horrible Blue Monday in February? Or would you like to read that in the sunny, sunny July beachy weather? I don't know. It's tough to pick, right? So yeah, Notice will be coming eventually. Right now I'm enjoying the living heck out of Ronald Malfi's Small Town Horror. I put a post on my blog about how I've been reading quite a lot of Small Town Horror, and my review for Withered is probably out already. That review kind of kicked off me wanting to read more small town horror. The Haunting of Velkwood was coming up. This was coming up. So I knew I was in for a lot of treats because I really love small town horror. And it's not just the Stephen King of it all that I think has put us into loving that sort of setting, you know, a small town with really well-wrought characters that we feel that we've known if we're from small towns. I think it's from being from a small town, not growing up in the city and not growing up in the real deep countryside, although I did spend formative years on the countryside and I have an affinity for rural horror as well, but small town horror. So far, this is fantastic. So yeah, I see a lot of other booktube friends reading it, a lot of people on my Instagram who have also seen posting photos of it. Just fantastic stuff. So yeah, I'm looking forward to talking more about this. Before that, fiction and nonfiction, poetry and all kinds of stuff. The latest Bookworms is out. It's a rock and roll issue. There's some interesting worm art in this. I'm not the hugest fan of the art all the time, but I do like the wraparound cover with sort of a Beatles mania kind of feel going on in this. But there is a review by Will Erickson. There's lots of great short fiction in here as well. And some of the asides, like the little Q&As and stuff, I really enjoy them, even if they're humorous. I really picked this up for the nonfiction this time around, though. So if you haven't picked up Bookworms already, check out Regina's Haunted Library and follow Bookworms on Instagram. You can find them at the Etsy store to order the print copies yourself. Otherwise, there are no digital copies, although they have been talking about it a little bit. But for now, it's old-fashioned zine-style print only. So this brings us to the tiny, tiny haul section. It's not all horror. There's like really a horror book here, or like maybe horror sci-fi. The Island of Dr. Moreau by H.G. Wells. This is a really old little book. This sold for 95 cents at Kohl's bookstore here in Canada. It looks like it's never been opened, never been read. It has no markings in it at all. And it still has that price tag from Kohl's bookstore. So this might have been printed in 1968, sold at Kohl's, and never touched. So I really like this. I probably got this for a dollar. So I paid 5 cents extra. Eats, Shoots, and Leaves by Lynn Truss. Just a grammar book that I collect some of these seminal books that most writers have on their bookshelf. There's a few gaps. Like I have my E.B. White, I have Woe Is I have a style book. I have all kinds of books on writing over there, like on writing. But Eats, Shoots, and Leaves was one that I always wanted to have. I'd had read it in college, but I had borrowed a copy from the library for the assignment we were doing on it, and I just haven't bought a copy till now. And I wanted not a digital copy, I wanted this sort of copy because it's got some extra ridiculousness in it. A punctuation repair kit of stickers, which I'll never use, but I think it's just adorable. And pandas, I got it for a dollar. Also for a dollar on that same thing, just like a mini coffee table book. I think of these as bathroom books, but it's called I'd Rather Be Reading, A Library of Art for Book Lovers. So it's not really reading. It's basically, it's a printed Instagram page, really. That's what it feels like. Just talking about the art of books. And I'm not the hugest fan. Like, you might think that this is an aesthetic bookshelf, but I don't spend a lot of time really arranging it. It is a collector of knickknacks more than anything. But I've seen some really gorgeous aesthetic book things, and I've shared on my Tumblr, which I'm not very active on. It's almost all aesthetic books, right? And like libraries. I love that. So I thought this would be a nice little diversion for some Sunday afternoon when I'm looking for something light to read. I just like the cover too. I'd Rather Be Reading. In the sci-fi section, they have like a mixed fiction that is separated sci-fi. They don't have a horror section, but in the sci-fi sort of area, sci-fi fantasy, I found my pal Kate Hartfield's book, Alice Payne Arrives, and it looks mint. Like, no one has touched it. It was probably like extras they got at the library, because they're very good for stocking local authors at the library here. And because I know it's in the library and it's a popular book, so I was very surprised to see it there. Alice Payne Rides Again is another, and I have another Kate Hartfield book sitting on my shelf. I hadn't read this, and I'm very excited to read the Alice Payne series, and I really like the cover of this, actually. I also really, what I really want to get into is her novelizations of Assassin's Creed stories. I'm not sure if they are based specifically on the game or just within that universe. So if you like fantasy, historical fiction, and soft sci-fi in some respects, definitely check out the Alice Payne series. Also for a dollar, why not some Dean Koontz? I don't like this bright yellow, orange, green stuff that goes on a lot of his books. So this is like an ugly spine for an ugly book. The Face of Fear, one I'd never heard of, but I like the synopsis. So a dollar it is. This was also a dollar. It's not in the best repair because the spine has been sunned, but it is a very old copy of Christmas Carol by Charles Dickens. It's got a very interesting inside. Herbert Strang's Empire Library is the publisher. It's also got that kind of green color that makes me worry that it's arsenic. So I don't know, we'll find out when I get arsenic poisoning, won't we, kids? To Dorothy, love from Annie, Christmas 1933. So yeah, it's been fairly well cared for. It's a little bit broken with these, probably from people showing off how gorgeous of a book it is. And yeah, it's otherwise pretty well cared for, hardly cracked. It's A Christmas Carol and the Chimes. So yeah, I really am excited to have this and as an addition to my very old books up on the top shelf. And there was like a horror book, The Demonologist by Andrew Pyper, which I've been looking forward to reading. It's been on my list. My husband noticed it among the hardcovers there, and it was probably a dollar. I think maybe $2, but it's in perfect condition. I've been meaning to read it for a while, and I may be seeing Andrew Pyper, Nick Cutter, other authors. I think he's going, actually. at a convention in September. I'll have more on that another time. It's called DreadCon. I don't know much about it, but I bought a ticket anyway, because a Canadian horror writers convention, I'm in. Before I get going, I have noticed that my podcast feed is not working from Spotify because I had a little bit of a divorce from Spotify myself, and I had not realized that my Anchor account and Spotify were linked to the point that my closing my Spotify account, my personal listening Spotify account, would mean that it took my podcast down. I don't know why I did not do that math, and I'll figure that out. Hopefully I can fix the RSS feeds. If I can't, I'll put a note up redirecting everyone to the YouTube podcast version of the show, I suppose. So if you've had any trouble listening to the podcast, if you've come here because of that, I apologize. I'll try and fix it. I'll have an update if I can't. But anyway, yes, it's broken. Speaking of conventions, StokerCon happened not long ago, and I wanted to do like a little wrap-up video because the video on YouTube is very hard to listen to. The audio was not good. So I'm kind of debating doing that. Did anyone here go to StokerCon, or have you watched the video? Did you just turn the volume way up, or do the closed captions work? Let me know if you were able to enjoy watching the Stoker Award ceremony on YouTube. I'm not like digging on the StokerCon convention group at all, or Horror Writers Association. It's an annual tradition where we sit down to watch it here, and we couldn't because it was just, we had to crank the volume up and it was fluctuating too much. And unfortunately I wasn't able to watch it. So I've just been relying on reading the list. So I don't know if I can download the transcript or something and at least follow along with what was said. Yeah. Shame that I have to miss it almost every year live in person, but it's a double shame when I have to miss it electronically like that too. So hopefully next year all those technological kinks are worked out. Other than that, are you reading Small Town Horror by Ronald Malfi? Or have you been reading other small town horror books? Or are you from a small town? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you very much for watching, and have an ooky, spooky day.